We celebrate your doings in our midst. We celebrate your victory over the enemy in our lives. And we thank you for the light of your word that is coming to us. Spirit of the living God, take over. You are our teacher. We have come to hear your voice and not the voice of your servant. We have come to receive from you. Bless us by the light of your word. Enlighten us today. Give us that light that will make us the people that you have created us to be. And let the name of our Lord alone be magnified. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
We thank God for such a wonderful time. And we're going to continue on with what we began last week. We touch on what we call the power to become. The power to become. The power to become. And we were made to understand that the believer is nothing without the power of God. The believer is nothing. Or let me put it this way. Christianity is a burden. Christianity is a struggle without the power of God. It is a struggle without the power of God. So the Bible says, as many as received them, to them gave he power to become. So it means that you are supposed to become somebody, and what it will take for you to become is the power. So he has given you the power to become. The word to become implies that it's a process. You have been given the power to become. To become. Glory be to Jesus. And we also made to understand in the book of Psalm 74 verse 9 that we see not our signs. There is no more any prophet, neither is there any among us any that know how long. We see not our sign. So there is what we call our sign. I mean, you personalize it, your sign. There are some signs that must manifest in your life as a child of God, but you are not seeing it because you haven't come to know what you have to know in order to do what you are supposed to do for the signs to manifest. You know, so this is the power we are talking about, the power to become. The power to become. And so we see not our signs. We are not seeing it. I mean, as born again persons, some things are expected to be seen of you. There are some things that must just manifest automatically in your life. But we see it not. We are not seeing our signs. That means that something is wrong somewhere. That means there is something you and I must know, which we don't know yet. But praise God, by the Spirit of God, we are going to know it. In the name of Jesus. And Amos 8 from 11, he made us to understand, not the famine of bread, nor of the water, but the hearing of the word of God. So here, we are talking about why we haven't become. And the Bible is saying, behold, the day cometh, saith the Lord, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, nor a thirst for water, but of the hearing of the word of God. And so, the lack of knowledge of the word of God, or the farming of the word of God, not hearing the word of God, is what is not making us to become what we are supposed to become. So as a result, verse 12 says that, let's go to 12, and they shall wander from sea to sea, and from north even to the east. They shall run to and fro to seek the word of God, and shall not find it. So as a result of the farming of the word of God, they run to and fro. They wander, they become wanderers. They become people that are running after everything, being blown about by every wind of doctrine, because they are in the farming of the word. They are not hearing the word. Therefore, the light of the word has not dawned on them, and that is why they are running around. They are wanderers. And this is the reason, one of the reasons why Jesus has given us the power to become. The power to become. So the to become also has to do with the ability to know the truth, the ability to understand, because until you know the truth, you cannot become. Are you understanding me? We said it last week. The basis of our power is the word. That is why Paul said, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God. It is the power. So until you know the word, you cannot be empowered. So you have been given the power to become, the ability to know in order to become. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And so we want to continue on from there. And today we are calling it Understanding Your Divine Nature. Understanding is a continuation, but with a different topic. Understanding your divine nature. So now we know that we have been given the power as the children of God to become. We have been given the power to become. And everyone that is born again is born as a sign and a wonder. Because the mysterious thing that can ever happen in this world is born again. The highest of miracle is born again. And so when you are born again, it's a mystery. You have become a sign. You have been born as a sign. You have been born as a wonder. It's a mystery. It's the greatest miracle. As a matter of fact, it's the only miracle that shakes heaven. Are you understanding me? That is why the Bible says, when a soul comes to Christ, that is when one person is born again, the whole heaven is thrown into our party. The angels are screaming and shouting and dancing because a soul, that greatest miracle has happened. Are you understanding me? Apart from that, there is nothing other miracle that happens that moves heaven. I mean, even if somebody dies and you pray, the person comes back to life, it doesn't move heaven. Are you understanding me? But when a soul is born again, because like we studied it some few weeks back, the only thing that demanded the life and the blood of Jesus was the salvation of man. Every other miracle did not demand that. I mean, Jesus was performing all kinds of miracles before he died. I mean, dead were coming back to life. We see it in the Old Testament. I mean, walking on the water, feeding 5,000 people with a little food. And miracles upon miracles. Calling Lazarus out of the grave after he's been buried for 4 days. All these things did not demand his life or blood. But there was only one miracle that could never happen until he went to the cross. And that was the salvation of man. And so that tells you that is the greatest miracle. That is the greatest miracle. So when you are born again, you have to take time to understand who you are in Christ. That is what puts you above the enemy. The ignorance of who we are in Christ is what makes us, you know, behave like ordinary people. But you will not be ordinary in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I said you will not be ordinary in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And so when you are born again, you have to understand that you are a walking miracle. Are you understanding me? The born again alone makes you a miracle.
Amen.
You are a walking miracle. You see, you are going to have to be conscious of this in order to have dominion of the affairs of your life. You are a walking miracle. You are not somebody people must pity. You are not somebody that is running around looking for somebody to help you. You are the person that must be looking for who to help. Because you are born by the Spirit of God. I know by the end of this message, the Holy Ghost is going to make us to understand what it really means to be born again. Born again. Because the new birth, you know, brings you into a new sphere of existence where you cease from being a struggling human being. Are you getting it? When you are born again, it brings you into that realm of existence where you cease to be an ordinary person, where you cease to be a struggling human being. You now become a commander of signs and wonders. That is the mystery, the born again. Because the moment you got born again, the Bible says, all things passed away. Behold, all things have become new. All things, not some, all things. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. All things. And so the new birth is described as being in Christ. If any man be in Christ. So the new birth put you in Christ. It put you in the class of Christ. So the new nature now is the divine nature that has been infused into you. So the old you, the human nature that makes you cry, that makes you struggle, that makes you get sick, that makes the enemy torment you, is passed away. That one is passed. Now Christ is come in. The divine nature is come in. The nature that cannot be defeated, the nature that cannot be sick, the nature that cannot be harassed, the nature that no devil can stand against, that is who you are now. Divine nature. Understanding your divine nature. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Now, the lack of this is what is making people go to church and still struggle. They go to church, they are still afraid of little witches and wizards. They go to church and people just harass them and they get away.